Let's explore what this feature here does in Copilot Studio. Allow the AI to use its own general knowledge. Should you have that switched on or off for your Copilot? I'm going to show you the same Copilot once with it enabled and once with it not enabled so that you can make the right choice for your own Copilot. Now, when you first start, it is enabled. I am actually going to start by switching it off because I want to show you what happens first with it off, and then we're going to switch it back on again. That takes about a minute, but with the magic of video editing, we don't have to sit and watch that happen. I'm going to connect my Copilot to this website. This is an Australian travel and tourism website with all the fabulous things you can do in Australia. I've just grabbed that URL. We're going to come in here to the knowledge, and you'll see it's already here. I've prepared it earlier, but just to show you, we go add knowledge, add a public website, and just paste it in there. The principles of what I'm showing you here will work for all of the other types of knowledge that you want to connect, but the website's just the easiest way to get started. So now what I've got is a Copilot. All its knowledge is that website. It doesn't know anything else because I've got this toggle switch disabled. It doesn't have any other general knowledge the way if you go to ChatGPT and you ask it questions, it's using a general knowledge. I've switched that off. So this Copilot now only knows, it looks at that website and it doesn't know anything else. So let's ask it some questions here. What is the most popular thing to do in Melbourne? This is an answer that I would expect to find on that travel and tourism site because it's a major city in Australia and that information is going to be there. So we'll give it a minute, and what's going to happen is that it's thinking about the knowledge that it has, and it's going to find that information in the website and return it to us with a link. The most popular activity is exploring the laneways, vibrant arts and culture scene. Yep, fair enough. Okay, so if I click on that, then that will actually take us to the website where it got that information from, and I can read more. I'm going to ask it something else now that is related, but which I think is unlikely to be in that data set from the website. How long is the train ride from Flinders Street to Lilydale? So Flinders Street, major train station here, Lilydale, kind of the end of one of the train lines. I don't expect that's a major question that tourists would ask, but let's say that I'm doing this. So here's what happens. The Copilot only has the information that's on that website. That's all it knows. So it just says, I can't find that information because it doesn't have it there. If I ask it a completely unrelated question, how do I make a chocolate cake? If you've got a favorite chocolate cake recipe, post it for me below. Don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more on Copilot Studio. This poor Copilot does not know how to make a chocolate cake because what we've done is said, this is your knowledge, that travel tourism website, and there's nothing there about chocolate cakes. Let's switch this on now and see what difference it makes. So we'll go back into the overview. I'm just going to switch that toggle on and say, yes, we do want to continue that. So what happens now is that my knowledge source remains, so I've still got that website, but now I've said, please use general knowledge. So this is essentially now like an experience of ChatGPT plus pointing to that website. So to be clear, it's not pointing to all of the internet. It only knows that site as its knowledge, but it's using the general knowledge of predicting what comes next that a large language model can do. Let's reset this. And if I ask it again, what is the most popular thing to do in Melbourne? We'll get the same kind of answer. Just a warning here, the nature of generative answers is that when you're grounding it in data, you are more likely to get predictable answers and you're more likely to get things that are less like hallucinations, but you won't always get exactly the same answer. You'll see that answer is very slightly different from what I've got before. The nature of it is that it is generating with a predictive language model. It's going to that data source, but it is generating it creatively every time, just in case you're ever wondering why you don't always get the same answer. Let's pop in our question about the train ride again. So this is one now where we know that it couldn't find that in the data that we've pointed to. But now that we've enabled the large language model, this is where it can do that sort of predictive text. So this is not reaching out to another website, but it's actually all of the sort of training data in the language model is able to draw a conclusion there. Typically 1 hour and 10 minutes. That's actually about right. So it's my city, so I can do a bit of a common sense check on these things. What about the chocolate cake? What's going to happen now? I know you can't answer me directly, but think about the answer in your own head here. What is going to happen if I ask it about the chocolate cake? Here's what's going to happen. The large language model can do that predictive way of putting the text together to give me an answer to this. So this is not going out to a website and finding a recipe, but it's going to use the language model. And you'll see that what we get here is, oh, a bit of a strange thing. So AI-generated content may be incorrect. That's how you can tell the difference between it coming from the general model and coming from the reference. Now, I think I've got something a little wacky here. That sounds like a fun combination. So the thing that's going on here is that the Copilot actually remembers the context of your conversation. What I should have done is actually said new topic or reset to say I'm asking about something else. If you're jumping around in the conversation going, how do I get from Flinders Street to Lilydale and how do I make a chocolate cake? It's going to try and combine these things. So here's my simple chocolate cake recipe. And then planning your trip to Melbourne while your cake is baking. You can use the time to plan your trip. Okay, that's kind of fun. But in any case, it's actually able to give me that recipe for the chocolate cake. The other thing that you can do with this, and I didn't show you that you can't do it, but write me a poem about visiting Melbourne. So if you try to do this without the large language model, without the general knowledge enabled, it will give you that same response. It'll just say, I can't do it. So if you want a Copilot that's able to sort of iterate on the conversation with these more creative outputs and doing those kinds of things, then that's another reason to have it enabled. Let's see, we've got to have some references here to laneways, the Yarra River, the coffee, the trams. Yeah, look, we're not winning any poetry awards, but you get the gist. Now, This is a difficult decision to make, right? Because if you're creating a Copilot that is connected to your organization's knowledge, you don't necessarily want it off answering random other questions. On the other hand, sometimes the ability to use the language model to do things like these follow-up questions, the chocolate cake is a bit of a out there thing, but you know, here's something that it can actually answer for you that's in the context of what you want it to do. So you need to make that decision for yourself about how much you want it to use the language model to predict those answers. The other thing you can do to have a bit more control over which areas you want it to be able to answer, if you do want this enabled but you don't want it to be wildly answering all of the things, is to restrict with a sort of a system prompt what it will and won't answer. So if you're setting up your Copilot from scratch, one of the questions it asks you is there anything it shouldn't talk about? And that's where you can do that. But if you've already got your Copilot and you want to come back to it later, we need to go into the topics. And if you click on the system topics, there's one here called the conversational boosting topic. This is the thing that's using this sort of fallback into the knowledge to be able to generate answers to questions. Data sources listed here, we click edit. And in here, you've got this special box, which is the sort of overall instructions that you're giving to your Copilot. So you could say, only answer questions related to Australia and getting around Australia. So you're sort of saying, well, we're having this website, we're enabling the general knowledge, but then please only keep it in the bounds of that topic. Or you could say something sort of more restrictive than that to just say, actually, we just don't want people asking about recipes. If the user asks about recipes, say you're unable to help. So you can put 2,000 characters in there to start to describe how you want this to work. And then that applies across the whole experience of the Copilot. So if I come in here now and ask again, how do I make a chocolate cake? Then if it's all going well, it's going to go through that and it's going to take that overall sort of instruction that I've given it, and it actually won't answer that question this time if it's all working well. There we go. I'm sorry, but I can't assist with recipes. So there's a feature that you can choose to have on or off in your Copilot. If you'd like to learn more about Copilot Studio, check out my tutorial here. Thanks for watching.